Hi, I'm Sean Rice from the International Tour of the Addams Family, and welcome to Gaming Out of Suitcases. In Zombies, you and five of your friends find yourself in the middle of a town square of a town filled with zombies. You can either kill 25 zombies or find your way to the helipad before one of your friends does and leaves you for their all-you-can-eat zombie buffet. Now, during the playthrough, I'll be tweaking the game's rules slightly to make it work for a solo game. But let me first tell you how it works on a normal game. Everyone starts their character on the town square. Deal out 3 action cards to each player and make sure everyone has 3 bullets and 3 hearts to begin with. On your turn, you will flip over a town card and place it on the board, connecting it to another street location. Now, there are 2 types of town cards. There are generic street cards and there are specific location cards. If you pull a specific location card, it will tell you exactly how many zombies to place, how many hearts, and how many bullets. You can place a zombie in every legal square within the building, and the hearts and bullets as well, but hearts and bullets cannot share a same space. If you pull a generic street card, count the number of exits on the card, and place that many zombies on it. If you have less than 3 action cards, draw 1 from the deck. Now roll the dice. That's your movement point for this turn. Each point counts as 1 square that you can move on to. Now, if you are on a space with a zombie when you start, or if you move on to a space with a zombie, you must combat that zombie before you can continue your movement. To fight, roll the red dice. If you roll a 4, 5, or 6, then you've killed the zombie and you can take it as a trophy. However, if you roll a 1, 2, or 3, then you're in a fight with the zombie. You can either spend a heart to re-roll the dice completely, or you can spend any number of bullets to make that number a 4, 5, or 6. Let's say I rolled a 2. I could then spend 2 bullets to make it a 4, and I can collect that zombie as a trophy. If I don't defeat the zombies and I lose my last heart, then I'm dead. I get put back in the middle of town square, and I lose half, rounded up, of my zombie trophies. But when I start my next turn, I do get to start again with 3 hearts and 3 bullets. After your movement is completed, you'll roll the white dice again, and you'll move that many zombies 1 space. Use this to your advantage and move them towards the other players or create an opening in the path for yourself. Finally, if you want to, you can discard an action card to the discard pile. Action cards can be played throughout the game to help yourself or impede your fellow players. They can be played any time. However, if you play one, you can't play another one until it's your turn again.
Got it?
Let's have a playthrough.
Okay, in this playthrough of Zombies, I'm going to be playing a solo version of the game. So the rules are almost exactly the same, except it's, of course, just going to be me. Whenever I have to move zombies, I've got to move the zombies that are closest to me. I'm going to start myself because I'm a little, you know, more down and out because it's just me against the world. I'm giving myself the full 5 hearts to start with. I've also got 3 soldier guys set aside to be my lives. If I lose all 3 of my soldier guys, then the game is over and I've lost. I start with the same amount of bullets. Everything else is the same. I've got everything set up here on my zombies, my cards and everything. The way the cards will work, I'm not going to give myself any of the cards to start off with. However, I am going to draw a card at the end of each turn, and if it's a good card, I can still only hold up to 3 at a time. I can keep it. The weapons I can't use until, you know, they tell me I can on the card. If it's a positive thing, I can hold on to that and use it whenever I need to do it, holding only 3 cards in my hand. However, if it's a negative card, then I have to make that happen the next turn against myself. If there's a positive or negative result, then I've got to choose the negative and make it happen. Cool. So, the way it'll start, I've got my dude here in the center, in the town square. I pull a card, and as you can see, it's a regular street scene with 1, 2, 3 ways off, so I'm going to be having 3 zombies. And we'll put that there. I'm going to try not to build out of the line of sight too much. And set my 3 zombies up. Alright. So now I'm going to roll my dice to find out my movement. I rolled a 2. So I'm going to start killing zombies. 1, 2 is all I can move. Now I'm going to fight. So I'm going to roll my dice. Remember, if I get a 4, 5, or 6, it's killed. If I get a 1, 2, or 3, then I can either use a heart to re-roll, or I can use a bullet to add to the dice roll to make it a 4, 5, or 6. I, of course, rolled a 1. And I've only got 3 bullets, so I'm going to lose one of my hearts right away. So I'm going to take my heart and sit over here to reroll. And this time I rolled a 5. So the zombie is now dead. Okay. Now I roll for zombie movement. I can move 6 zombies one space, so I have to move the ones closest to me. So if she, of course, is moving there, he's moving there. And now I take a card. This isn't so bad. Move any 2 zombies in play to any legal space. So I would have to move them towards me, and they're actually as close as they can get to me, so I'm not going to do anything else with those at the moment. So I'm just going to discard that card. And have my next turn. So this time I've drawn the Sporting Goods Store. As you can see, it has going to 6 zombies, and I'll have 2 lives and 4 bullets. So I'm going to place that here. And we'll put the bullets and lives out first. So, life 1. Bullet 1. Life 2. And bullet 1. 2, 3. Oops. Bullet, life. Now, when I move on to one of those spaces, if there's a zombie there, I've got to defeat the zombie before I can claim the life or the bullet. But if there's no zombie there and I move on to the space, I can just take it. I don't have to stop my movement or anything. Every space in the building will have a zombie. Okay. Perfect. Now I'm going to go for my movement. I've rolled 3. Okay, so first I'm going to deal with this zombie. 6. So I got 1. 6. 2, 3. I'm going to clear them out if I can. Okay, so now zombie movement. 6 zombies can move 6 legal spaces. Okay, so obviously, they can only move through doors, so that's 1, 2, 3. We'll cycle them 4, 5. And he'll stay there. Now we take a card. Claustrophobia. Player may not enter any building during their next turn. If in a building, the target player must use all the movement to exit in the shortest route possible. So it looks like I'm not going into the Sporting Goods Center next turn. I will not be able to move there. Alright. As you can see, the board starts to build up really fast with these cards. Nothing special here, just 2 exits, so I get 2 more new zombies. I have to put it in a legal space. So I'm going to go ahead and put it here, because we can still see there. And put 2 more zombies on the board as close as possible to my space. There we go. Okay, so first we'll roll for what my movement will be. 1, that's fine. Now I'm going to kill the zombie first. I've rolled a 2. I'm going to use 2 bullets to make that a 3-4. So I'm getting rid of those 2 bullets, because hopefully I'll be able to go into there and pull up some bullets. So, dead. I can't go in the building though, so I'm going to forfeit my movement actually and just stay where I am. Zombie movement. 1 zombie. Obvious choice. He's going to move right on to me. Cards. Butterfingers. Choose a target player, which has to be me. That player must discard a weapon or item in play or up to 2 bullets of your choice. Okay, well, I have no items in play. So, I've got to discard my only remaining bullet. There we go. Very sad. Alright, so my movement will be 5. But now I gotta kill the zombie. I've rolled a 4. So this zombie is dead. Bam! 1. Take the bullet. 2. Fight the zombie. Rolled a 3, we'll use the bullet. Make it a 4. Guess what? I'm taking another bullet. All right, so that was 1, 2. 3. We'll just kill this zombie. I can't have more than 5 lives, which I don't have right now. I've got 4. So if I kill the zombie, then I can take that life. 2. Instead, I'm going to use a life to reroll. 3, and I'll use my bullet to pop it up to 4. Bam. Taking the zombie, and I'll then take the heart. Bringing me up to 0 bullets and 4 hearts. Alright, so that was 1, 2, 3, 4. Tried to kill this zombie. I rolled a 6, and I did. So I'll take that life. That brings me up to my total of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 5. There's no zombie there, so I can just take that bullet. Bam! Clearing out the sporting goods store. Zombie movement. 5 zombies will move towards me. Obviously, he's moving here. Bump. Bump. Adrenaline Rush. This card is played before making any die roll. Target player may double movement for 1 turn or add +2 to a combat roll. Wonderful. So I'm going to hold on to that until I need it. All right, so now we're adding space. This time we've got the gas station, which as you can see has 3 zombies, 1 life, and 2 bullets. Gas station will go here. And we've got 1 life. 2 bullets, bam bam, and a zombie in every square. Now again, I'm looking for the helipad, or I'm trying to get 25 zombies. I currently have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 zombie trophies, so I'm good to go. Oh no, sad day, I'm going to roll my other die just for now. 4, that'll be my movement, now I've got to kill him. 6. Did it! Oop, that was me. Alright. So 1, pick up the bullet. 2, 3, 4. Zombie movement. 5. Okay. I'm gonna go get that dice. Dice is retrieved. So 5 zombies may move. There's 5 zombies on the board. So 1, 2, they're coming for me. Bomb, bomb, and he's actually stuck there because he can't move. Okay, wonderful. Try a new card. Chainsaw. Play this card when you are at the garden and lawn center, which I haven't found yet. Discard the item to gain +2 to all combat duels for the rest of your turn. So I'm going to hold on to him, and I can't play him until I'm at the garden and lawn center. I do have 2 cards in front of me, which means I can only have 1 more card in my hand when it comes time for that. Here we are, a regular space. 1, 2, 3 ways out. We'll put it right. Actually, we'll put it right here. 3 more zombies. Putting them as close to me as possible. All right. And continuing on. Movement. 3. 1, 2, 3. All right. Zombie movement. 3. 3 zombies will move. Closest 3 to me. 1, 2, 3. All right. Card. Where did everybody go? It says to play this card any time. To move target opponent 5 spaces, all zombies encountered must be fought as normal. I'm going to say this to mean that when I take this card on a solo, that I have to move myself through 5 zombies currently. So starting next turn, instead of movement point, I'll have 5 and I have to move through as many zombies as possible. Yeah? So that'll happen to me next turn. Okay. Beginning of that turn, again, just a 3 spacer. which we'll set here, giving us three more zombies. We're starting to get a lot of zombies on the board. All right, my movement will be in the five. So, not including this one, I'm going to start killing this one. Three, I'm using one bullet, bam, to kill him. Okay, so one, shoot three. Whew, that's one more bullet. Two. I rolled a five. Three, four. I rolled two. That's unfortunate. I have no bullets. I have to get rid of one life. So I'm down to four lives to roll again. Six. So that was one, two, three, four, and I'll end my turn there if I don't die. And I didn't. I'm quite the zombie killer currently. All right, and as you can see, I'm down to still have three lives, got four hearts. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 zombies. Halfway there. Hallelujah. Okay. All right, now I'm going to look at the zombie movement. Four zombies are going to move towards me. Obviously, that's one, two, do three, and four. Those are the closest to me. Okay. And now we look at the cards. This isn't so bad. Move any two zombies in play to any legal space. All right. So we'll just put that in play right now. I'm moving these other two zombies closer to me. Next turn. Ah, we've got random street with two exits. There's two more zombies. Right at the edge. Sometimes they face the wrong way because, you know, they're zombies. Alright, so my movement for this turn will be... three. I'm going to try to fight the dude here. Six. Bam. One. Oh no. Lost another life. I'm down to three. It's a three. Oh shoot. Lost another... Oh, you know what? Okay. Lost another life. I'm down to two. However, I'm going to use my Adrenaline Rush card to give me a plus two to this next combat roll. Which is good because I needed it. Alright, so I killed this one. So that's one, two. I have one more movement. I'm going to go in here and try to get some bullets. Three. I got to kill this one first. One! Oh no! I'm down to one heart! Five. Ah. Killed it. Took Mr. Bullet. Alright. That gives me one heart, one bullet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 zombies. Woo! It's getting close. Four zombies are moving my way. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm cornered inside the gas station. Card, what happens? Skateboard. Place this card in front of you when you are in the skate shop. It gives you plus 2 to all of your movement rolls. Skateboard is considered a weapon. So when I find that... hold on to it for now. Got two cards in my hand. Here we are. We found the hardware store, which has three zombies in it, one life, and two bullets. Hardware store's going right here. Closest to me. One life, two bullets. Place them in there. This is the only door, but as you can see, one, two, three, four, five, there's five spaces in the hardware store. I'm gonna make it easy for myself. Put one on the life. There we go. Okay, my movement is going to be 1. Fabulous. So I'm going to go over here and pick up this heart. Zombie movement is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll say 5. And we'll move this one 6. Okay. Card. First aid kit. Play this card when you're in the hospital or the drugstore. You may discard this item instead of losing health token as a result of combat. All right, so I'm going to hold on to that. Can't play until I'm in the drugstore or the hospital. And it's time for a new card. The helipad! Bum-da-da-bum! All right, so I have to place him legally on the board. He has 4 exits. 1, 2, 3, 4. The only place I can place him legally is going to be... That's not just here off the town square. Is going to be... we'll put it as far away as possible from where I am. So we're going to stick it down here. Show you where that is. So now I've got to get from there to there. Let's see if it happens. All right. Oh, and as you can see, the helipad also, by the way, has no bullets, no lives, but 9 zombies. So a zombie on every space. So fill this up with zombies. Three, 4, 5, 6. Once you find the helipad, when you play a solo game, I kind of like to play that you have to, if you find the helipad before you get your 25 zombies, then you have to go for the helipad. You no longer are looking at collecting zombie trophies. That's the goal. But you have to spend 2 turns in the center of the square when you're playing the solo game, the way I play it, to succeed in leaving. So I've got to be on the square clearly for 2 turns. So I got to get there and do that now. That's my only goal. Okay, so helipad down. My movement... is, of course, 1. So I'm going to come over here and kill this zombie. But, of course, I rolled 1. So I'm going to, oh my gosh, lose my heart. 2 roll again. 6. Success. Alright. Now, zombie movement. 5. The 5 closest zombies to me are going to move towards me. 1, 2, 3, 4, and we'll move this one here, 5. All right, so they're still coming at me. Card. Much needed rest. Play this card instead of making a movement roll. Gain 2 health. Awesome. So now I've got 4 cards in my hand. So what I'm going to have to do is discard a card to be able to keep this one. So I'm going to go ahead and discard the skateboard because odds are I'm not going to find that building. And I need this much needed rest because I only have 1 heart left and 1 bullet. So, beginning of my turn. We get a new location, which is just a space. So we'll stick that here. Actually, we'll put this here. So there'll be more zombies closer to where I'm going, making it harder for myself. When you play solo, you always have to sabotage yourself because no one else is there to do it. Alright, so I got 2 zombies there, a bunch of zombies there, and there's another over there. The reason these aren't moving over in this corner, by the way, is when you play solo, you always have to move the zombies that are nearest to you. When you're playing with any other people, then you can move any zombies anywhere on the board. Just remember that. Okay, so instead of my movement, I'm going to play my much-needed rest card, which gives me 2 health. So I'm going to take my 2 hearts, giving me 3 hearts and 1 bullet. Oh, right. Perfect. Now I'm going to fight the zombie because he's on my space. I rolled a 3. So I'm going to spend this bullet to make it a 4. Bam. Bam with a bullet. Zombies near me. Only one's going to move. That's okay. Only one is really close to me. Butterfingers. That player must discard a weapon or item in play or up to 2 bullets. Well, I have no weapon or item in play, and I have no bullets, So I'm just going to choose a card out of my hand that's a weapon and make myself discard the chainsaw. Whoops. There we go. Okay, so now all I have is a first aid kit in my hand. New area. Just a street. We'll play him down here as well. Giving us two more zombies, because there's two exits on that street. Bam, bam. We can see we got more town down here. I wish this table were longer, that I could show you the whole thing. Right. So my movement this turn is going to be 6. Wonderful. Now I'm going to kill the zombie. 4. Bam. Killed him. I'm going to waste 1 to pick up this bullet. Actually, 2. So that's 1 movement. Gives me 1 bullet back. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's my movement. Aiming towards the helipad. Dun, dun, dun. In fact, I'm going to scoot this all up now. It's unlikely I'm going to head back up this way if I don't have to. Now you can kind of see a little more of everything. Okay, perfect. Zombie movement. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll still move these. 5. I want to keep as many on the helipad area as possible. 6. To make it harder to get through there. Okay. No one reached me though, so I just look at my card. Adrenaline Rush. Adrenaline Rush. This card is played before making any die roll. Target player may double movement for 1 turn or add +2 to the combat roll. I may do that to try to get over to the helipad. Still adding zombies in. We did find the drugstore, which is good for me because that's where my first aid kit is. I'm going to put it down here, moving this up even more so we can see. Bum, bum, bum. There we go. All right, so now we've got the drugstore down here, which does have 3 zombies, 3 lives, no bullets. And we can see our helipad and everything else a little more clearly. So I put my 3 lives down in there, because I think it may be smart for me to try to go and collect these lives and get my first aid kit going. Oops, sorry for my arm. Before I move on to the scary helipad area. But it doesn't mean getting through these zombies. Okay. Those are down. I'm going to use my Adrenaline Rush card, which gives me +2 to a combat roll. So I'm going to roll. Oh, I'm sorry. Also gives me double my movement points for 1 turn, which is what I'm using it for. 3. So I get 6. 1. Roll to 3. Use the bullet. Bam. 2. Whew, roll to 6. 3, 4, 5, 6. Gets me right outside the door. You can almost see me down over here. There we are. Alright. Perfect. Now, zombie movement. 2 zombies. Obviously, this one's going to move towards me, and this one's going to block the door. Alright. Excuse me. My card is lots of ammo. Play this card in front of you when you're in the sporting goods store. Discard the item to gain 3 additional bullets. The sporting goods store is around, so that's awesome. I'm going to hold on to this. Okay. So now we're adding on. We've also found the florist shop, which has 3 zombies, 1 life, and 1 bullet. The florist shop, I'm going to put over here by the helipad. That way, we've got some more zombies that can come up from the behind when it starts to move. Alright, 1 life, 1 bullet inside there. Bam, bam, and 3 zombies. Okay. So my movement for this turn is going to be a 5, But first I've got to kill this zombie. One! Lose one life to reroll. Three. Oh, I have no more bullets, so I have to lose another life to reroll. This may have been a bad choice for me. Six. Okay. So my movement is five. So I'm going in. One. Trying to kill the zombie. I did roll a four, though it hit the zombie. That shouldn't have happened. Okay. So I get this life. So that was one in. Two. I get this life. Three. Four. If I kill the zombie, I will also get this life. Putting me at a total of four. I rolled three, which means I actually have to use one of my lives to roll again. Six. Okay. Cleared this out. Got three health. I'm in the space, so I'm going to use my first aid kit, which again, play this card when you're in the hospital or the drugstore, which I'm in. You may discard this item instead of losing a health token as a result of combat. So I'm going to play it in front of me. Know it's in play. Then I can use that instead of a heart, basically, is what it's saying. Okay. Now, zombie movement. Six zombies are going to move towards me. Well, let's start moving. I don't want to move the helipad just yet. So, one, two, three, four, five, and six. Actually, five and six I won't move. I'll move these guys over here. Five and six, so they can start to line up this way. That is more accurate to what would happen. Okay, new card. Fear. Tiger player may not move by any means during their next turn. So I am scared and stuck in the drugstore. We found the police station, though. Police station has six zombies, two lives, and four bullets. We'll also place the police station down here. So we have a lot of zombies that can come out. Actually, we're getting tight on this table. I'm going to place it over here, at the edge here, so these zombies will be coming out this way towards me. Four bullets are in there. One farther away, the better. Three, four. We've got two lives. And a zombie in every space, of course. As you can see, what turned out to be, what started out to look like an easy game has turned into a zombie-filled, horror show. Alright. So, police station is out. I cannot move. And so, therefore, just zombies will move. And five zombies will move towards me. Alright. So, we've, of course, got one, two, there really was. Three. Really one more to go. Four. I'll move this one over here. Five a little closer. Okay. Claustrophobia. Target player may not enter any building during their next turn. If in a building, target player must use all movement to exit by the shortest route possible. Which kind of works, because that's where I was going to do anyway. Okay. Four-way cross-section for zombies. Where to put it is the question. We'll set it over here next to the zombies on the helipad. And we got one. Oops. Two. Three. And four. So now we've got zombies over here, zombies everywhere. Alright. My movement, which has to be out of the building. Four. One, two. Do I want to go risk it and go to the police station? I don't think I do. Three, four. Okay, zombies moving towards me. Six of them. Closest first. One, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes. Okay. Brain cramp. Play when another player begins their move. You may decide whether or not the player moves. Okay, I'm going to say that that means that I do not move again. Brain cramp. So I'm stuck. Meanwhile, the army surplus store has come into view, giving us 2 more zombies and 2 more bullets. Put that over here by our other 2 zombies. Zombie front the door, zombie there. And 2 bullets, even though I probably will never head over there, you never know. Okay. I can't move, zombie moves. 3. Moving 3 zombies towards me. Closest, closest, closest. Keys are still in it. Move up to 10 spaces in place of making a movement roll. You must fight zombies as normal. Alright. Nice card. I will definitely be using that this turn. Here we found the toy store. 3 more zombies, a life and a bullet. I'm going to tack that on over here. Throw a life in there. Throw a bullet in there. And 3 more zombies. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, perfect. Alright, so keys are still in it, using this card to give me 10 spaces. I'm getting the heck out. 1, 2, 3, 4. I rolled a 3. I have to use a life to roll again. I rolled a 3. This is... I'm going to use my first aid instead. Discard that to roll again. I rolled 1. I have 2 lives, so using 1 down to 1 life. And I rolled 1. I just died. Okay, so it goes away. I am now going to... If this were a regular game, I would lose half my zombie trophies. I'm just going to throw them all in there because zombie trophies don't really matter right now. But I'm also going to lose 1 of my life tokens. I have 2 more chances. I also have to start back in Town Square, which is actually kind of the direction I was going, so it didn't work out too bad for me. But there is a zombie already there. Every time you restart, you would normally start with 3 bullets and 3 lives. Remember, I started the game with 5 lives, but I'm only going to give myself 3 lives here to restart the game with because it doesn't seem fair to have 5 every time. So I'll give myself 3 bullets, 3 lives. I've got 2 lives to go, and I still have 1 card in my hand, which is my Lots of Ammo, so if I end up near the Sporting Goods store, I can get some more bullets. Which actually I may do, because there's nobody over there right now. Okay, so my next turn is starting. Oh, zombies still would move as normal. So I still roll for zombies. 2. I have to finish my turn. I died there, but... So, moving towards here. Yep, and card for starting the next turn. Issues untied. Divide target player's movement roll in half, rounded down. So, it's not a good way to start. Now I would start here. Okay. New space. 3 ways out. Which means I'm getting 3 more zombies. We'll stick them right here. So many zombies! Alright. My movement is 1. Rounded down. In half rounded down, I guess is 0, so I'm not going anywhere. I do have to fight this zombie. 3, I'm spending a bullet, bam, to kill it. Zombie movement, 2. 1, 2. All right. My card. We're screwed. Play zombies on 10 legal spaces where there are no zombies. And they have to be where it would be harmful to me. So obviously anywhere leading up to the helipad. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we'll do 9, 10 on the way up to the sporting goods store because I have already stated I wanted to do that. All right, we're screwed. It's true. Good news is 2 more new zombies are coming and that's all. Closest to me, I guess, would be here. I'm running out of space on this table. With 2 zombies right at the edge. Okay. My movement is 6. Perfect. Fight the zombie. 4. Bam. Dead. All right. 1. Rolled a 6. Dead. 2. 6. Dead. Whew. 3. 1. Lose a heart to reroll. 6. Dead. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 is dead. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's 5. Oh, bam. 4. And my last movement would put me on the center square. 2. I'm going to go ahead and use my 2 last bullets to bump that up to 4. Kill this one. Now I've got to spend 2 turns here for, in my house rules of solo playing, to consider it a win. So, this is my first turn here. My zombies still do get to move because they would, of course, crowd around as I'm trying to get away. 5 of them, of course. So we'll move 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. Still get a card. My movement is going to be divided in half. I don't plan on moving, so that's not a biggie. I do, just for the sake of doing it, I'm adding 1 more space on here, as close as I can to where I am, which will be way over here where you can't see, with 2 more zombies that will eventually move towards me. Here they are. Okay. But I'm here in the center, in fact. Let's zoom in on the carnage of what's going to happen. Here we go. Okay. All right, so my movement is 6 divided by 2, so it's 3, but I'm not really going anywhere. I just have to survive this turn here. So, I rolled 1. I have 1 more bullet, 2 more lives, so I'm using 1 to roll again. And I rolled a 5. Bam! 2 turns. I'm good. Flew off in the helicopter. I won the game! So as you can see, zombies can be a lot of fun as a solo game. It's also great when you play with other people. But if there's no one else around, you can go ahead and play on your own. There's a couple different variants out there. You can find them all on BoardGameGeek.com. But it's a great fun game. It's easy to travel around, and that's how you play it. So be sure to come back on Sunday to check out Living Out of Suitcases, and then next Sunday for the new Gaming Out of Suitcases. Bye!